students, how are you? I hope you all are fit and fine. So dear students, as you know that we are discussing sample paper 1. So as of now we have discussed till question number 10 and part 1 and 2 of question number 11 too. Today we are going to start this video with part 3 of question number 11. Let us begin. Question number 11, part 3. The question is, what were the contents of the small suitcase? What were the contents? What were the contents of the small suitcase that McCleary carried? McCleary carried. Okay. What were the contents of the small suitcase that McCleary carried? So as we all know that this question has been taken from Evans, Tries and O level. From that chapter it has been taken. So we have seen in that chapter how prisoner Evans wished that he wanted to complete his O level. Then jail authorities made all the arrangements, and finally how he escaped from the jail. It was really he used his wisdom. So how cleverly he planned all the things. So before that day also he had escaped the jail many times. So that is why this time the jailer took all the precautions, the governor took all the precautions. Anyhow, in any condition, he did not want him to escape from the jail, but they could not stop him. So we have seen how the tutor who used to come to teach Evans in the jail. So how they both made a plan, as he was his friend, and how they tied the examiner at his home. At the end of the story, we have seen he was found tied in his home, and how the examiner who came that day having a suitcase, in suitcase he took all the items like papers, knife and all other articles which he needed for the examination. One more thing which he bought, which he brought, it was a ring, okay, and it was filled with blood, but he pretended that he was having the disease of pile, so that is why he had brought it to sit on it. Okay, so finally how cleverly Evans escaped from the jail in this story, as we have gone through already. Okay, so let us write answer to this question. The small suitcase of McCleary The small suitcase of McCleary carried contained a sealed question paper. Contained
sorry, it's wrong. Contained. What were the contents of the
small? Let me check.
Yes, it should be contained here. Sorry.
And what is in the question? What is in the question? Yes, okay. Contained a sealed question paper. It was containing a sealed question paper. Envelope, a yellow invigilation form. A yellow invigilation form. What more it carries? A special authentication card. A special authentication card from the examination board. From the examination board. A paper knife, a Bible, the current copy of Church Times. The current copy of Church Times and a small semi-inflated rubber ring. Small semi-inflated rubber ring. So these are the things which were inside McLeary's suitcase. What were the contents of the small suitcase that McLeary carried? So the small suitcase of McLeary carried contained a small a sealed question paper envelope, a yellow invigilation form, a special authentication card from the examination board, a paper knife, a Bible, the current copy of Church Times, and a small semi-inflated rubber ring. Okay, so these are the content which it was having. Okay, so let me rub it and write down the next question. Now let us discuss question number 12. Answer any one of the following questions in 120 to 150 words. Question number 12. Answer any one of the following questions. Answer any one of the following questions in 120 to 150 words. In 120 to 150 words. Okay. Now, question number 1. Desire, determination, and diligence. Determination and diligence. Desire, determination, and diligence lead to success. Diligence lead to success. Desire, determination, and diligence lead to success. Explain the importance of these qualities Explain the importance of these qualities in the light of Douglas. In the light of Douglas. In the light of artist LAS. In the light of Douglas, experience in deep water. Douglas, experience in deep water. Okay. Desire, determination, and diligence lead to success. Explain the importance of these qualities in the light of Douglas' experience in deep water. So, as dear students, we have seen that in the chapter Deep Water, when Douglas was of 3 or 4 years old, he went to California beach with his father. And he was knocked down. He was knocked down by a violent wave of the sea. Since that day, he had a fear of water. When he grew, he wanted to raft. He wanted to, you know, all the adventurous sports. He wanted to go through all the adventurous sports related to water, but he could not do it. He determined, he gathered the courage and went to learn how to swim. One day when he was sitting nearby the swimming pool, one boy of something 18 years, he was of 10 years, a boy of 18 years came and he threw him into the water. So we, how he described the moment he was thrown into the water and how he was planning when he would go to the bottom, he would kick and he would come back again. So thus he also here gave us a message that there is a fear in death, and in death there is a silence. Later he hired instructor. So with the help of instructor, he could learn how to swim and he could enjoy all the adventurous sports related to water. So thus, dear students, we have seen how desire, determination and diligence helped Douglas to overcome his fear and to become a successful swimmer. Okay, so let us write down this answer. Desire, determination and diligence. This is long answer type question. It is of 5 marks. Okay, so we have to write this answer in detail.
Desire, determination, and diligence, and diligence, desire, determination, and diligence
is a combination of attributes and abilities.
Is a combination of attributes and abilities
that drive people to set goal,
that drive people to set goal,
that drive people to set goal for themselves and then to take the initiative
for goals for themselves and to take the
initiative to achieve these goals.
To take the initiative to achieve these goals.
To take the initiative to achieve these goals. The narrator of the story Deep Water.
The narrator of the story Deep Water.
The narrator of the story Deep Water shows how one can cross. Shows shows how
one can
how one can cross any hurdle with positive attitude and courage.
One can cross any hurdle with positive attitude
with positive attitude
and courage.
Desire, determination and diligence is a combination of attitudes and abilities that drive people to set goals for themselves and to take the initiative to achieve these goals. The narrator of the story, Deepwater, and should be small here, we need not capitalize it. The narrator of the story, Deepwater, shows how one can cross any hurdle with positive attitude and courage. Okay, I'm going to rub it and going to write the remaining part of this. Douglas, the narrator, had a deep-rooted fear of water.
Douglas, the narrator, had a deep-rooted fear of
water. The terror of water followed Douglas wherever.
The terror of water followed Douglas wherever
followed Douglas wherever he went
wherever he went
to get rid of it he made a strong determination
To get rid of it, he made
a strong determination.
He made a strong determination.
He decided to overcome his fear.
He decided to overcome his fear
through his willpower.
Through his willpower.
He engaged an instructor who would perfect him in swimming.
He engaged an instructor who would perfect him in swimming. Who would
perfect him in swimming? The instructor first helped him drive away his fear.
The instructor helped him. The instructor first helped him in drive away his fear.
Drive away his fear. And then taught him how to exhale and inhale in water.
And then taught him how to inhale and exhale in water.
Now, last paragraph. The practice went on for months together.
The practice went on for months together. The practice went on
for months together. During which his fear came back to haunt him.
During which his fear came back and haunt him.
His fear came back and haunt him, but his dedication and firm will,
but his dedication and firm will,
but his dedication and firm will made him persist in his efforts.
Made him persist in his effort, in his efforts.
Okay, so Douglas, the narrator, had a deep-rooted fear of water. The narrator of the terror of water followed Douglas wherever he went. To get rid of it, he made a strong determination. He decided to overcome his fear through his willpower. He engaged an instructor who would perfect him in swimming. The instructor first helped him in drive away his fear and then taught him how to inhale and exhale in water. The practice went on for months together during his fear, during which his fear came back and haunt him. But his dedication and firm will made persist in his effort. Okay, let me repeat and complete this answer. So let me the remaining part of this answer, I'm not going to write it on the board. Let me dictate and you can write down. It was only through sheer determination. It was only through sheer, S-H-E-E-R, sheer determination and diligence. It was only through sheer determination and diligence that Douglas could not only counter his terror, but also became an expert swimmer. He swam, next paragraph, he swam across and back large distances. To ensure that his fear of water did not return. Hence, now give the conclusion. Hence, desire, determination, and diligence succeeded in removing his fear of water. Okay, dear students, so it's all about this class. In my next video, it's all about this video. In my next video, I will discuss the second part of this question and question number 13. Thank you for watching. See you tomorrow.